제니다 어 가도하네 자다 어디 되는 데게 이니 에 자다 남배 쉬고 나러네 이니 디 쉬시 응아게 안다 야가게 다 가서 우리 그게 좀다 두수다 앞에 잡아 쉬셔도 와디 가서 모질로 더 못 하다 해야 돼 에 예매 타라 에노 다도 세븐 주거든 무슨 두배 가서 두배 주고 써야 다 어디서 무슨 다 똑배지 유는 죽죽이 캐봐 먹고 쉬시다 남배 두주다 집엔 두주 잡아 쉬셔도 와 시부지 캐시 버리자 유진 시베 유제룰이야 맨날 그렇게 얘기해도 되지 시간 내가 시 버리자
So this fact, this point about how two truths, the principle of two truths, really should be understood in terms of two different perspectives on one and the same world is very important because it directly touches upon our understanding of the relationship between our perception and the reality of the world. Perception and the objective world. And so we find in the Indian Buddhist literature a tremendous amount of discussion, debate, and analysis about the way in which mind or consciousness perceives the world and what is the nature of the relationship between our subjective experience and the objective world, to what extent they are constitutive of the world that we experience and to the world that we perceive. So I think, the reason why there has been such a tremendous discussion and the debate and analysis is because, you know, the understanding of that plays a crucial role in one's development of mind and training of the mind.
No, yeah. 다 어시 담바니 여바 인자네 람탑시니 다른 데 묵군이 있다도 시야래.
So the Buddhist tradition argues that since in reality there are two truths, the conventional reality and ultimate reality, therefore corresponding to those two levels of reality are two dimensions of the path, the wisdom path and the method path, or the skillful means path. And because there are two principal dimensions or aspects to the path, there are also two aspects to the state of Buddhahood. One is the form, and one is the actual reality of the Buddhahood, Dharmakaya, and Rupakaya, the form body and the truth body of the Buddha.
That's what I just said. You should check. Damsala in the Kamaju Nishun, Ngar Tancho, Shiru Tancho, that's what I'm saying.
So it's already 11:30. If we are in Dharamsala, we can have more flexibility with time. We can stop 10 minutes later or earlier and so on. But here in the West, we have to be very punctual. So we'll stop.
Ready. Thank you. Yeah, that's enough. That didn't get any touchy, Nig Duyagi, then debut on the Kudela, Namuda disagree, Shandun Sugu Sata, Ramdun Chugu Sachi. A carasana, Shandun Sugu Sadi, Dujel Mons Nanakone, that Sung Chile, Chiba Jugendi. 제가 책임을 띠 간다 숙숙고 위에 있잖아요 드는데 보다디 아니 샹준 무스팅에 되면 되는 샹준 숙고세 아다 드는데 보다 아니 가서 그게 매밀 흔들고 수도 숙고 매밀 흔들고 샤르냐 지금 드는데 아니 가서 그게 빵서 타다 아니 최진수 세니 아니 네 Any Kandada, any Yishi Tartu with the top Yundu, and dating Sukum Bemilundu Shakya, the Yungi Vaidusane, any Chuyuku on the Mas, on the Snam to the Chuyuku Matova, any Shandus Bemilundu Shaya, Sukuti to the Mavice, Tadanaya, Shishi Chuguti, Rang Yuniki Kasa Korang Musu Chuyu Mado, Snam to the Kanda, Sayan Ampers of Konechu Mado, Dujel Mosna Kone, Kushantishi to the Mavindusane. 아니 람드 추구스 신어도 독슬라이브리
We spoke about earlier there being on the basis two truths. Corresponding to that, there were two aspects of the path, the wisdom aspect and the method aspect. And we also spoke about how the resultant state of the Buddhahood is also constituted by the two dimensions, the form body of the form embodiment of the Buddha and the truth embodiment of the Buddha. So, and these two aspects of the Buddhahood, for example, the form embodiment of the Buddha is said to be that form of the fully enlightened being which exists purely in relation to others. Now, this is because by assuming these diverse forms and appearances, the fully enlightened being engages in all kinds of activities to fulfill the welfare of well-being of other sentient beings. And whereas the truth body of the Buddha is said to be that form of the Buddha or that embodiment of the Buddha which is in relation to Buddha himself or herself. Now the reason for stating that is because the expanse of the reality, that is the Dhammakaya, is directly accessible only to a fully enlightened being. So, and it is only through assuming or through the medium of assuming various forms of embodiments that the Dharmakaya can manifest and engage in activities that are beneficial to other sentient beings. So the resultant state of the Buddhahood is therefore can be seen as the fulfillment of both one's own self-interest of the individual and also the fulfillment of the interest of the others.
That the Sholo Tambu Gubudigi, Guru Chenju Sem Jonga Che, Tupin Nanjo Che, that the Sholo Tamadigi, Tandu Chenju Sem Gomia, Dunyu Gomia Dimri.
So, in these eight verses of Training the Mind, the text which has been distributed, the first seven verses deal with the practices associated with cultivating this method aspect of the path, such as compassion, altruism, aspiration to attain Buddhahood, and so on. And the last verse, the eighth verse, and deal with the practices that are directed towards cultivating the wisdom aspect of the path. The first verse reads, by thinking of all sentient beings as even better than the wish-granting jewel for accomplishing the highest aim, may I always consider them precious. Now in these four lines, thoughts and reflections on how to cultivate a sense of holding dear all other sentient beings is presented. And here, the main point that is being emphasized is to develop an attitude or a perspective that would enable you to hold other sentient beings as precious, something like a precious jewel.
Yeah. That day, any you semjan na zhe bu zhe ya de jumze kar ya shena.
Now the question could be raised: on what grounds, do we need to cultivate the thought that other sentient beings are precious and valuable?
Lamjin Negroine, Dado, Debu Negroine, Dado, Kadachi, Chosimjan, Dene, and Pusu Sawatanja Yonga Chadi, or is Dona Shi Negroki, Chita Sangu Yande, Chita Sangu Digi, Sangu Cha, Didi, Sisimjan Yungu, Lamjin Negroine, Chip Pusu Sawati, Sisimjan Yungu Yari. 데뷔네급이 산지에게 그게 칠레 매밀 흔주 세대야디 이 칠레 죽세 유심전에 땡땡에 땡땡에 타네 제니 고 간단 가서 그게 진짜 무슨 내면도 저하지 무슨 차등이지.
So in one way we can say that other sentient beings are really the principal source of all our experiences of joys, happiness, and prosperity, not only at the level of ordinary existence in our ordinary day-to-day life, when we deal with people, and also in our own ordinary experience of joys and pains and happiness and so on, we will see that all the desirable experiences that we aspire to attain, that we cherish, really are dependent upon cooperation with other sentient beings, and it is an obvious fact. Similarly, from a practitioner's point of view, even on the path, many of the high levels of realization that you gain and the progress that you make on your spiritual journey are also dependent upon cooperation from other sentient beings and also interaction with other sentient beings. Also, at the resultant state of Buddhahood, the truly compassionate activities of the Buddha can come about spontaneously without any effort, only in relation to sentient beings, because they are receptive or recipient of beneficiary of these enlightened activities. So through these way, one can see that other sentient beings are, in a sense, the true source of all our joys, prosperity, and happiness. It is very obvious to all of us that many of the prosperities and successes of mundane existence are dependent upon other sentient beings. Such basic factors of our happiness and comfort of this life, mundane existence, such as food for sustenance, shelter, clothing, companionship, all of these are dependent upon